the development of new forms of farming, agriculture, and cattle breeding at the beginning of the Neolithic allowed increasing the volume of available products. This led to a numerical increase in the populations of Mesopotamia, Anterior Asia, Egypt, the Indian Peninsula, and China. At the same time, the increase in population density and daily contact with domesticated animals led to attacks by new species of viruses and bacteria on the human body. They have also led to a rapid spread of new diseases in densely populated regions. It was in these territories that the first epidemics of diseases erupted, echoes of which we find when reading ancient religious texts. Athenian Plague. The first historically documented epidemic was the outbreak of the Athenian Plague in 430 BC. Modern scientists assume it was typhoid fever. This disease, according to the Greek historian Thucydides, came from Ethiopia in transit through Egypt to the Greek cities. At that time, Sparta and its allies waged war against Athens and its friendly cities. Athens was besieged by the Spartans, and the influx of refugees became a catalyst for the outbreak of the epidemic. Approximately 27% of the population of Athens and Athenian commander-in-chief Pericles have died as a result of this disease. This greatly contributed to the victory of the Spartan alliance. The Antonine Plague. In 165, the Antonine Plague broke out in the Roman Empire and raged until 180. This disease took the lives of about 5 to 7 million people, which accounted for about 2% of the world's population at the time. Most likely, it was common smallpox, which was native to China or East Asia. At this time, the Romans actively fought with Parthia, whence this disease came. The infected warriors returned home and gave the disease to other inhabitants of the empire. The Eastern Roman legions lost 26% of their strength, significantly weakening the empire's military power. It is assumed that the next significant epidemic of the plague of Cyprian, 249 to 262, was caused by measles. As a result, the population of the city of Rome decreased from about 500,000 to 190,000 people. These pandemics have led to a significant depopulation of the Roman Empire, an increase in the cost of manual labor, and a reduction in the profitability of slavery. In addition, these fearful misfortunes led to the Romans' disillusionment with the old beliefs and the spread of Christianity as a religion of salvation and hope. The Plague of Justinian. The cold temperatures of the early Middle Ages and the extremely cold summer of 536 led to a catastrophic decline in crops, a new round of migration of peoples, and an increase in the populations of hungry black rats in cities and villages. It was these animals that became the spreaders of bubonic plague bacteria, which settled in rat flea organisms. These insects also fed on human blood. Also, plague bacteria mastered the way of airborne transmission. At first, the plague spread in Central Asia and China, from where trade routes spread it to Byzantium. In Byzantium, the first recorded plague of Justinian was in Pelusium in Egypt in 541, from where it quickly spread to other cities of the empire. Constantinople was severely affected, with a 65% decline in population. Over time, the disease spread throughout the Mediterranean and Western Europe, where outbreaks continued until the early 8th century. The total number of casualties during these years is estimated at between 20 and 70 million. The plague spared no one. Even Pope Pelagius II died from it. This epidemic significantly weakened the eastern provinces of Byzantium and the Sasanian state. In the 7th century, the Arabs took advantage of this by conquering the Sassanid kingdom and the devastated Byzantine provinces. Black Death. The Black Death was the second major pandemic of the bubonic plague. Its source also comes from the steppes of Central Asia, where the Mongols ruled in those years. In 1346, the troops of the Golden Horde, struck by the plague, laid siege to Kafu, which was then held by Genoa. The attackers were unable to acquire the city, but threw it with the rotten corpses of their soldiers, who were afflicted by the plague. Plague bacteria began to infect Genoese traders, who spread the disease rapidly across Europe by sea. The plague spread rapidly because of widespread poor sanitation, lack of hygiene, feudal warfare, inadequate treatment and preventive measures, and weakening of the body due to malnutrition and fasting. The plague pandemic, 1346 to 1353, killed between 20 and 45% of the population of then Europe. The population has been reduced by 2.3 times, and the total number of deaths has reached between 27 million and 200 million worldwide. Only Poland, Milan, and parts of Bohemia were spared. In the territory of modern England and Norway, the number of inhabitants decreased 2 to 3 times, in France 1.7 times, and in Venice and Paris, almost 4 times. The victims of the Black Death were King Alfonso XI of Castile, France Queen Joan of Burgundy, and Prince Simeon of Moscow. In the fight against the epidemic, isolation from potential carriers of the disease and respect for social distance has proved most effective. In 1386, the first quarantine for the newcomers was introduced in Venice, which lasted 40 days. Intercontinental disease exchange. Large geographical discoveries have also led to a large intercontinental exchange of diseases. So Europeans brought influenza, typhoid fever, measles, and smallpox into the New World. The most deadly for the Indians was the latter. Some 52 to 85% of Native Americans died of Old World diseases. This led to the destruction of most of the Indian civilization and culture, and made it easier for the European colonizers to advance and conquer. In response, Europeans received a new version of syphilis, which is actively sexually transmitted. In 1496, the disease spread to Italy, France, Spain, and Portugal. In 1497, to Germany and England. And in 1498, to the whole continent. The spread of this disease in Europe led to the disappearance of public baths and increased religious conservatism. The total number of deaths caused by syphilis has exceeded 5 million. The military and prostitutes were among the most vulnerable. For example, in the early 19th century in the Russian army, 12% of all personnel had syphilis. Cholera pandemics. One of the biggest troubles of the 19th century was cholera, caused by Vibrio cholera bacteria, which is transmitted through food and water. The first cholera pandemic, 1817 to 1824, began in 1817 in the area of Sundarbans, Bengal. Then the disease spread to all of Southeast Asia, the Near East, and the Eastern Mediterranean. The estimated number of casualties has reached 4.4 million. Thanks to new means of transportation, trains and steamboats, Vibrio cholera bacteria rapidly penetrated into industrialized Europe and the United States. During the second pandemic, 1826 to 1837, cholera affected almost all regions of Europe except Scandinavia and northeastern Russia. It also affected the Near East, North Africa, the southeast coast of the United States and Mexico, eastern Canada, South Asia, Persia, East China, and Japan. The number of victims has reached more than 2 million. The third cholera pandemic, 1846 to 1860, affected South and Southeast Asia, East China, Korea, Japan, the Near East, North and East Africa, Mexico, the USA, and parts of South America. The cumulative number of casualties has reached more than 1.4 million. Four other large-scale cholera pandemics later occurred, claiming the lives of millions of people. Cholera took the life of former King Charles X of France in 1836 and James Polk in 1849 in New Orleans. In 1893, the composer Peter Tchaikovsky also died of cholera. Influenza pandemic. Influenza is an ancient disease, most likely transmitted to humans by domesticated chickens or pigs. The greatest danger of flu is its rapid mutations and the emergence of new strains to which most people are not immune. Outbreaks of this disease in Europe are described in detail as early as 1510, but the most deadly was the pandemic of the so-called Spanish flu, which from 1917 began to mow soldiers on the Western Front during the First World War. Appalling sanitary conditions in the trenches, lack of adequate medical care and cleaning materials, physical weakness of the military, and frequent hypothermia contributed to the pandemic. Tens of thousands of soldiers on both sides of the conflict were dying from a new version of the flu or passing it on to civilians. However, military censorship banned the dissemination of the shocking truth about the flu, and therefore the first to report the extent of the disease was unfettered Spanish media. Hence, we got the name of the disease, Spanish flu. In 1918, the virus quickly spread to all continents except Antarctica, bringing the total number of infected to no less than 560 million. The Spanish flu caused the deaths of between 24 and 100 million people. Extreme lethality, sometimes over 21%, and the rapid spread of the Spanish flu forced the authorities of various countries to institute restrictive measures, such as local quarantine, restrictions on businesses, wearing masks in public places, and handshake ban. The large-scale epidemic prompted the governments to begin building an effective medical system that would serve the entire population. AIDS pandemic. In 1981, the human immunodeficiency virus was first investigated and discovered in the United States in Atlanta. The virus affects the immune system and causes AIDS, acquired immunodeficiency syndrome. AIDS makes people vulnerable to other viruses and bacteria. This disease most often spreads through unprotected intercourse and can also be transmitted through blood and cuts. From the beginning of the pandemic to 2019, 76 million people worldwide became infected, with about 32 million dying from complications. Currently, 35 million people are living with HIV, of whom more than 24 million are in Africa. India has 6.5 million people living with HIV. RPA has 6.2 million. Ethiopia has 4.1 million. Nigeria has 3.6 million. Russia has 1.5 million. The United States has 1.4 million. And China has 1.2 million. COVID-19 pandemic. At the end of 2019, a new coronavirus appeared in Wuhan, China, which was eventually classified as COVID-19. At first, totalitarian Chinese authorities concealed the scale of the speed and danger of the new disease, so the virus was able to take off and spread around the world. In 2020, COVID-19 spread rapidly due to a long incubation period, 8 to 14 days, and a high degree of infection. At first, the high mortality rate, which in Italy reached 14%, prompted most governments to impose severe quarantine restrictions. In many countries, people were even prohibited from leaving their homes. Wearing masks in public places became mandatory for some time. In most countries, a vaccination campaign was launched in 2021, accompanied by protests by COVID dissidents. Up to May 2022, COVID-19 and related complications had killed up to 6.2 million people worldwide and infected more than 530 million people. The U.S. suffered the most, with 84.2 million infections and 1 million deaths. Summary. Pandemics have taken a huge human toll. The Antonine Plague, probably smallpox, took up to 7 million human lives. The plague of Justinian, in more than two centuries, mowed down up to 70 million of the planet's population. The Black Death, in the 14th century, killed up to 200 million people worldwide. A pandemic of syphilis caused more than 5 million deaths. Cholera wiped out about 17 miles of Earth. Spanish flu up to 100 million. AIDS 32 million. COVID-19 6.2 million. In addition, pandemics have significantly influenced the course of world history, creating the prerequisites for changing patterns of economy, and contributed to the decline and disappearance of several empires and a number of civilizations and cultures of the New World. Deadly diseases in the 19th and 20th centuries encouraged society to invest more resources in medicine and improve the sanitary and epidemiological conditions of citizens.